Hi students, welcome to Justin NCRT Solutions. In this video, we are going to see 600 Maths Chapter 3 Exercise 3.5. First question, state true or false. Now we are going to see the statement. First question, option A. If a number is divisible by 3, it must be divisible by 9. If a number is divisible by 3, it must be divisible by 9. That statement is false, because if a number, according to the divisibility rules, if a number is divisible by 3, sum of its digit is divisible by 3, then that number is divisible by 3. And if that statement, we will take it number 1 plus 2 plus 3 is equal to 1 plus 2, 3 plus 3, 6. This 6 is divisible by 3, therefore that number is divisible by 3, but by 9 we cannot divide it. Therefore, that statement is false. So, if a number is divisible by 3, it must be divisible by 9. That statement is false. Next, option B. If a number is divisible by 9, it must be divisible by 3. If a number is divisible by 9, it must be divisible by 3. Because sum of its digit is divisible by 9. That number is divisible by 9, and 9 is divisible by 3, therefore that number also will be divisible by 3. And another one, that point, 3 is factor of 9, so if a number is divisible by 9, definitely that number will be divisible by its factor 3 also, so that statement is true. Next, third one, a number is divisible by 18 if it is divisible by both 3 and 6. If a number is divisible by both, if a number is divisible by 3 and 6, that should be divisible by 18, they said that, by multiplying like this. But here 3 and 6 are not co-prime number. If 3 and 6 are co-prime number, we can say that 3, 6 are 18. We can say that that number is divisible by 18 also. But here, these two are not co-prime number, because for 3, 1 and 3 are factor. Next, for 6, 1, 2, 3, 6. Here, two common factors are there. Therefore, 3 and 6 are not co-prime number. So, that statement is false. If a number is divisible by both 3 and 6, it must be divisible by 18. That statement is false, because 3 and 6 are not co-prime numbers. Next, option D. If a number is divisible by 9 and 10 both, then it must be divisible by 90. If a number is divisible by 9 and 10, definitely that number will be divisible by 90 also, because 9 and 10 are co-prime number. For 9, we have factors 1, 3, 9. For 10, 1, 2, 5 and 10. Only 1 is a common factor. So 9 and 10 are co-prime number. Therefore, that multiplication 9 tens are 90. If a number is divisible by both 9 and 10, that number will be divisible by 90 also. Therefore, this statement is true. Next, option E. If two numbers are co-primes, at least one of them must be prime. If two numbers are co-prime, at least one of them must be prime. That is false, because we have that proof here itself. 9 and 10 are co-prime number. 9 and 10 are co-prime, but these two are not prime number. 1, 3, 9. 9 is not a co-prime number. Sorry, 9 is not a prime number, and 10, 1, 2, 5, 10, this is also not a prime number, both also composite number, but these two are co-prime number, therefore that statement also false. Next, option F, that statement, F statement, all numbers which are divisible by 4 must also be divisible by 8. All numbers which are divisible by 4 that must be divisible by 8. That is false, because if that last two digits, for example, if you are taking number, if last two digits 1, 2, 4, last two digits are divisible by 4, means that number is divisible by 4. But for 8, last three digits are divisible by 8 only, that number is divisible by 8. So here this 124 is divisible by 4. You can check it. 3 4s are 12, 1 4 is 4, so 31. And here in 12 we have 18 is there, remaining 4, 44. Five eights are 40, so remaining 4 is there. So this number is not divisible by 8. Therefore, that statement is false. If a number is divisible by 4, it is not necessary to be divisible by 8. Next, option G. Statement: all numbers which are divisible by 8 must also be divisible by 4. All numbers which are divisible by 8, that should be divisible by 4. This statement is true. This statement is true because 4 is a factor of 8. Therefore, that number will be divisible by 4 also. This statement is true. Next. Option H. If a number exactly divides two numbers separately, it must exactly divide their sum. If a number exactly divides two numbers separately, it must exactly divide their sum. That is true. For example, if you are taking a number 6 and 9. 6 can be divisible by 3. 9 also can be divisible by 3. 2 3s are 6. 3 3s are 9. So now we are going to add these two numbers. 6 plus 9 is equal to 15. That 15 also divisible by 3. So if a number is dividing two separate number, then that number will be divide its sum also. So that statement is true. We saw the proof also. 6 and 9 is divisible by 3. So the sum 6 plus 9 is equal to 15. 15 also divisible by 3. Next, option I. If a number exactly divides sum of two numbers, it must exactly divide the two numbers separately. That is false. We will see that example. If you are taking a number 11 plus 9 is equal to 11 plus 9 is equal to 20. This 20 is divisible by 2. But this 11 is not divisible by 2 and 9 also not divisible by 2. Therefore, that statement is false. Okay, that's all, students. We saw all that true or false with proof also. If you like this video, you can share this video to your friends and give suggestions in the comments box and subscribe our channel. Thank you.